Hi, Jen. I will continue in English.
Okay.
What do you like most about a fish story?
I think what I love about film, which I've learned to love about film as well, especially after seeing the audience reaction over the last year where we've taken it out on the festival run, is that it's not only about entertainment, it has a power to heal, in the sense that I think everybody can relate to it from all generations. I can take my 12-year-old nephew to see the movie. I can take my mother. I can take my grandmother to see this movie. Everybody will relate to it in the sense that it's about family, ultimately. It's about love, and it's about redemption, and it's something that everybody can relate to. So I think what I'm most proud of is that, and I'm happy to, in terms of being a part of this project, is that we have seen so many stories where people, it gives people hope. You know, at the end of the day, I think that's what the movie does. It accomplishes something. It's not just about, yeah, let's go have a movie and see a movie and have fun, and that's all great, and there's nothing wrong with that. But I think this movie goes beyond in the sense that I think people really relate to it, and it gives them hope, and it's a great story, you know? It's a fish story. It's in, you know, is it true, is it not? It goes beyond. I think that's what's interesting about it for me.
Was it difficult to play with a child?
No, actually makes it really easy because they're real, and you just go along with what they're doing. They're not analyzing things maybe the way we do after years and years in the business. You try to, you know, come up with new things. At the end of the day, it's about just reacting to a simple situation. And usually, at the end of the day, it's your first instincts which are the truest, where you're really, truly in the moment. So I find that children, especially Jordan Negri, who's incredible in this movie, and she's it's her first movie, and she plays Charlie, and she works from instinct. So when you're with an actress who's working from instinct, then you do as well. It marries. And at the end of the day, I think that works because you give a truth to the scene. So for me, it was easy. Yeah.
What's the lessons the movie have taught you?
Lessons. I think it's about accepting people for what they are, and you know, this family is dysfunctional. I think at the end of the day, every family is dysfunctional, and it's about finding a truth to healing, and yeah, it's about healing. I think that's the biggest lesson in it, in the sense of to continue with your life if you've lost, and that life will continue when you've lost somebody, and it does. I mean, just it's a simple fact, but it's whether you choose to get up and move on with your life once you've lost somebody. Are you going to stall and hit the ground, or are you going to get up and go and fulfill your potential? That's the lesson, I think. Yes. Picture. Okay.
My last question is, what was the most difficult scene to play?
I have two. One was the scene in the water, simply because it was like only a foot deep, and I had to pretend that it was really, really deep. And the other scene was, I think, at the last scene, because if you didn't have that scene where she confronts him and says, "It is you, isn't it?" And make it believable, and it had to be believable in the sense that she had found, rediscovered her husband, and after everything that she'd gone through, she was willing to let him go and move on with her life. And that was that was what it was about. That's why he was willing to let her go as well. And it's a hard scene to for the just to make it believable and give people a sense of hope that not only is she willing to let go, she can move forward with her life and be strong again. Because obviously, when he dies, she's strong, and then she becomes this. She just goes off the rails. I mean, she's lost her soulmate. She's lost everything. To the point where she's actually willing to, she just forgets about her children to a certain extent, and she just recluses herself and self-medicates and everything else. So it has to be believable that she would reach a turning point and move forward in the sense that she could finally say goodbye to her husband, that he was going to be okay, she was going to be okay, and her family was going to be okay.
Thank you, Jane.
Okay, thank you. Good luck.